1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Hey! It is the price we pay. Over and over and over again.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Now listen. Okay, as we say in French, chose promise, chose due, meaning that the promise must be kept. Some of you requested me to make one video about my useless stop motion animation. And every time I explain step by step, they say, oh, it's too difficult. Okay. I got you. Let's start. And don't say that don't do anything for you. Okay, all right. So let's go. First thing first. Your timeline should be something like 24 or 25 frames per second. Don't go to the 30 or the 60, this is more work. So pick up one footage, any footage will do. I prefer to work with one green screen or blue screen because I like to future-proof my animation. By future-proof, I mean to reuse in other videos. That means if you got one plain background in one color already defined, more work to do. And also one paper texture, just Google paper texture, anything like this. Okay, so let's go now. So I got my footage of the last video. I already did it, but let's do it another time. Let's crop it. Let's put some keying. So far, so good. Spill level, let's reduce it a bit. And the fill hole, I will, just in case. To check the keying, I will take one other background, this time blue, just to check how the keying is going. Now it's okay. All right. Now, deactivate this one. With the wrench tool, select your footage. Export it as export image sequence. If you don't have this option, just click on add destination and you will see you just have to select it and put it in the menu. Let's export the footage as image sequence. You can choose between JPEG, PNG, TIFF files. I prefer to go with PNG. This one I will call it Fred. Motion. Done. Boom. And you see Final Cut Pro is doing the exporting. So now that Final Cut Pro exported our frames, we have to delete at least half of the frame. Something like every 2 frames, 1 frame must be deleted. So to do that, quite simple. And now one very simple recommendation, rename your frame to have some reference in case you are lost in the order. Very good. Take all your frame and just slide the frame or import with the menu in Final Cut. Here all the frame. Pom 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 pom. Lift it from the storyline. Now it's already grouped. Change the duration of the frame to 2. Oh. Let's see that. For the moment, it's not much, but don't worry about it. We are professional. Let's make it cute, sexy, and beautiful. We need the paper texture. Open the paper texture in Adobe Photoshop. We have to make one copy. Why? Because we need 2 versions. We need the original one, let's say the normal one, the brown one, and we need one dark one. But the dark one needs to be desaturated. Here we are, and after, inverse the color. Okay, so why I have the 2 versions of the same texture? Just because in with some color, I mean about the footage, your footage, when you will put the texture and you will blend it, sometimes the light will be better than the dark, or the dark will be better than the light. You will see. Import the 2 paper texture. Which paper I will use for the animation? I got the light one, I got the dark one. First thing I'm doing is I go and add, and I add it. Here we have the light one. We don't see much. Let's go to the dark one. Far better. Light, dark, light, dark. I still prefer the dark one. Usually I use the add, the lighten, the screen, overlay not so much sometime. So now we have the footage, we have the texture, but we are still really far from the hand. Put it in one timeline. Take it, cut it. Take it, move it, cut it, move it again, cut it. Play with the size, cut it. Play again with the size, cut it. All right, now to show you the result, this is like this for the moment. All right, don't worry about it. Put everything to frame. All right, take this one. Option click. Now, I want you to take the flip. All right, flip it horizontally and copy the flip to the other one. Take this one again. Up. Okay, so this is what we have at this stage right now, but we are far from the finish line. We need to decrease the paper texture opacity, change the length of some frame, also the exposure of some frame, and add one border around the silhouette to sell the stop motion effect to the viewer. Here come the boring part. This is the longest part. Now we are doing the border around the silhouette, and just keep in mind, it should look like somebody cut it by hand. That means don't try to go perfectly around. We don't care about that. Move to the next. Cut it. Don't try to match the previous mask. Okay, I want my straight line here. I delete one here. So if you did everything right, you should have something similar. Now we need to level up the quality of the animation, because at this stage it looks like a gift. And we don't want that. So select all the clips and readjust the length of the clips. I will go to 3 frames per clip instead of 2. So far, this is the speed I am looking for. Then I will select randomly some clips to increase the duration to 4 frames. And same thing, I will select other clip randomly and decrease the duration to 2 frames. Now time to complete everything. Select a custom background that we like as a border, place it under all the clips. Then to mask the texture, I will create a stencil by simply moving up the storyline of the mask and blend them as stencil alpha. Now choose your border color as it pleases you, and we are done. Done like almost done. For the color grading, I will just take one adjustment layer and apply a LUT into it. And now the beauty is in the details. So, you need to give different exposure to some clips to create one... you get the point. Now create a compound clip of everything, and we are just missing one thing. The halftone effect. You really don't have to, but just a teeny bit of halftone won't hurt. And it looks good. Let's finish it. Really finish. Use some speed ramping and some old frame if you need to, depending of what you are doing, and of course, depending of your storytelling. But as far as I'm concerned, we are done. So here the result. It's not bad, huh? You see. So far, I like it. I think it's okay. And we are done. So you see, nothing complicated. It just takes some time and a little bit of effort. Peace.